Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to Biology Online Classes. I'm Sadia Khatun, and today I'll be teaching you Mathematics of Class 6. I'll be teaching Chapter Number 8 of your textbook, and the name is Decimals. Children, you have already studied about decimals in your previous class, that is in Class 5. Okay? Tab decimals introduced hua tha aapke syllabus mein. What it is? Jab hum kabhi kisi cheez ko is tarah se likhte hain, suppose 24.32. This point in mathematics represents decimal. Tick. And how do we read it? We read it as 24.32. 32 nahi. Tick. Decimal ki baad wali cheezon ko hum log alag alag sare digits ko padhte hain. Okay. So this is the whole number part and this is the fractional part. So if you have to write the decimal in expanded form, you are going to write it as 20 plus 4 plus 3 upon 10 plus 2 upon 100. This is tens part and this is 100 part. Okay, so this is tens parts part and this is hundreds part. Similarly, this is ones and this is tens. इस तरह से रिप्रेजेंट किया जाता है डेसिमल को. अगर आपको एक्सपैंडेड फॉर्म में लिखना है तो आप इस तरह से डेसिमल को रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं. नेक्स्ट इज द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ डेसिमल ऑन अ नंबर लाइन. सपोज दिस इज अ नंबर लाइन एंड यू हैव टू रिप्रेजेंट 1.2 सपोज ऑन अ नंबर लाइन. सो सपोज दिस इज 0 देन 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 दिस इज 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is 2. If you have to represent 1.2, आप start करेंगे, आपको पता चल जाएगा कि 1 और 2 के बीच में this number 1.2 will lie. So 1 आपने लिया और उसके बाद आप right पे move करेंगे कितना? This is the first division and this is the second division. That means this is 1.2. ठीक? अगर आपसे कहा जाए 0.4, so 0.1234. This is 0.4. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. 2.5. This is 2.5. Is tarah se you are going to represent the decimals on a number line. If you have to represent a decimal into a fraction in the simplest form, how are you going to do it? Suppose I am taking an example. 4.5. 4.5 is a decimal number. Okay, and how you are going to represent it into a fraction? You will remove this decimal, and whenever decimal is removed, what you need to keep in mind is that after decimal, how many digits are there in this? Only one digit is there, and that is 5. So you will divide it by 10. If there are 2 digits after the decimal, then you will divide it by 100. If there are 3 digits after the decimal, then you will divide it by 100. Sorry, 1000. Okay, so here we will remove the decimal and we will divide this whole term by 10. So what do we get now? We get 45 upon 10. Can you simplify it further? Yes, of course. So you have to cancel it by 5. 5 9s are 45 and 5 2s are 10. 9 upon 2. This 9 upon 2 is an improper fraction and you can convert it into a mixed fraction also. So you will write it as 4 whole 1 upon 2. This is the final answer. Conversion of a decimal number into a fraction in the simplest form. The next topic is about like decimals and unlike decimals. Suppose that I take 3 decimal numbers. First one is 1.2, second one is 2.39 and the third one is 14.862. Suppose these are the 3 numbers, 3 decimal numbers. So in order to check whether they are like decimals or unlike decimals, you just have to see the digits, the number of digits after the decimal point. In this one, there is only one digit after the decimal. In this one, there are 2 digits after the decimal, and in this one, there are 3 digits after the decimal. What you need to do is, if you have to convert these unlike, because the number of digits after each and every decimal number, you can see that they are different. The number of digits after the decimal are different. So if you have to convert these unlike decimals into a like decimal, into like decimals, what you have to do, you have to, suppose in this one, there are three digits after decimal. So you have to make three digits in each of the numbers. So what you will do, you will put two extra zeros here. Why? Because you have seen that here there are three digits after the decimal. So you have to maintain that three number in each of these numbers. So here only two are there. So put one zero and you can see that there are in all the three numbers, we have made the number of digits after the decimal equal. Here also you can see three digits after the decimal. In this one also three digits after the decimal, and in this one also three digits after the decimal. That means now these set of numbers have been converted into like decimals. Children, the next topic is about the comparison of decimals. Comparison means you have to convert that which decimal number is greater and which one is the smaller one. So let's take an example, 24.83 and the other one is 248.3. Okay. So what you have to do, first of all, you have to look at the whole number part. Whole number part means the number that is before this decimal. So here you can see it is 24 and here you can see it is 248. So comparison to yahi se kar sakte hain. There is a clear comparison that 248.3 is greater than 24.83. Okay, suppose I am taking another example, 14.38 and 16.235. Okay, aapko sabse pehle kya dekhna hai, whole number part. Whole number part mein here it is 14 and here it is 16. Clearly this one is the greater one. If there comes situation in which the whole number parts of both the numbers are same, for example 28.32 and 28.302. okay, now this is 28, this is 28. That means the whole number part is same. So when the whole number part is same, then you have to move to the fractional part and then you have to see that which one is greater or which one is smaller. After decimal, here it is 3. After decimal, here it is also 3. That means similarity. Again, we have got the similar thing. Let's move to the next digit. Here it is 2 and here it is 0. That means which one is greater? This one is greater. You must be thinking ki why 32... you must be thinking that 32 is less and 302 is greater. So let's put this one greater. No. Just whenever you are comparing, you need to keep this in mind that you have to compare one digit by digit. If you just compare digit by digit, then you will definitely come to know that this is the greater one. Kya dekha? Second position par ki 2 is greater than 0. So, aap yahi se comparison kar sakte hain and you can tell that this one is the greater one. The last topic of this chapter is about addition and subtraction of decimals. Let's take an example from your book only. We have to add these three decimal numbers. So, let's arrange them in a column and then we'll add it. 12.7. Whenever you have to copy the next one, just keep one thing in mind that the decimal should be placed below the decimal only. That means 0.13 when you have to write, then this decimal will come here, this 0 will come here, 1 will come here and 3 will come here. Okay, this is the proper arrangement. Okay, the next one, the next digit is 7, this next number is 7.063. Now you must be seeing that these places are vacant. If you want, you can place the zeros here. At each vacant place, you can simply add, put zeros, that is up to you. Now we have to add 3, 6 plus 3 is 9, 7 plus 1 is 8, 7 plus 2 is 9 and 1 will be like this. So 19.893 is the final answer. The next one is subtraction. So let's take an example of subtraction. In subtraction also you have to keep one thing in mind and that is the decimal should be placed properly. Suppose you have to subtract 5.462 from 7.4. So from 7.4, that means 7.4 will be written first and then 5.462. You can see that these places are vacant. So you can put zeros here and now you have to subtract. Decimal will be placed below the decimal and now This will be 10. 10 minus 2 is 8. This will be 9. 9 minus 6 is 3. This will be 3. That means 13. 13 minus 4 is 9. And then here it will be 6. 6 minus 5 is 1. So 1.938 is the final answer, the difference of these two. So children, I have explained to you all the topics, all the concepts included in this chapter. I hope you have understood everything. If there is any confusion or any query, you can ask me in the live class. I'll explain you there. And the solutions and the notes of this chapter will be provided on School Mitra app. You have to go and download it from there and complete your work. And do remember Sadia Ma'am's rule that maths comes by practice.